confessed addict.
It started off when I was nearly 19, 30 years ago. It was then quite a fashionable thing to do, and I got immediately hooked. And I'll go to all sorts of lengths in order not to do without them. I mean, going for long, long walks to find any source of supply at all, sometimes even at 4 o'clock in the morning.
Professor Stone hardly fits the stereotype of the drug addict. His standing in society and his prestigious job set him apart from the conventional image of the addict. But so does his drug. Nicotine is legal and deeply entrenched in society.
I mean, if I haven't got it, I'm climbing the wall. There's no doubt about it. Nicotine does help with the concentration. Above all, when I haven't got it, I just fall into a state of depression. You know, the time will go by incredibly slowly with very little to show for it.
When you inhale a cigarette, you absorb 3,000 different chemicals, including tar and gases. The main objective is to get to the nicotine. Rapidly inhaled through the lungs, it takes nicotine only 7 seconds to reach the brain, a much faster process than if it were injected through the veins. Smokers claim they do it to calm down and help them concentrate, but nicotine increases the heartbeat and acts as a stimulant. In the First World War, cigarettes and gas masks were freely distributed to the armed forces, an appropriate reward for heroes. They came with the official stamp of approval. By the 50s, a tube of burning leaves had hooked the nation. 3/4 of the male population was addicted.
Nicotine is legal, so that it's very freely available, and until recently there were almost no circumstances in which you could not use the drug. You know, you could just dose yourself as and when you wanted. Now that's a very big difference from the illegal drugs. And it's really because of that that I say that it's almost the quintessence of an addiction, because there you can see drug-taking factors having free rein, more or less in the absence of social constraints.
Harry has been smoking since he was 9. He recently had a throat operation for cancer of the larynx and can no longer speak. Harry explained, "I have smoked all my life, probably thousands. Placed end to end, it would stretch from here to Birmingham."
You're smoking maybe partly for the kind of positive effects that you get from nicotine, but also the evidence again is accumulating that you're beginning to smoke for what we might call negative reasons. We know now that there is a very clear nicotine withdrawal syndrome, and you know, its characteristics are very well known to anyone who's ever been a smoker. It consists of being irritable, being miserable, restless, a bit depressed. And that comes on within a few hours of smoking your last cigarette. And smoking another cigarette is the sure way of avoiding it.
And the moment you put that cigarette out, that nicotine starts to leave, and you've created a hunger for poison. That is drug addiction. When you light the next cigarette, after just a few seconds...
Alan Carr once smoked 100 fags a day. He now runs a clinic to help people kick the habit.
Relax and calming effect. When you light up the next one, it partially leaves. Of course, you've now put more nicotine into the body. As soon as you put the next one out, that leaves, and now you're creating leave for the next, and the next, and the next.
With the pressure and coughing, I would actually make my nose bleed in the mornings, and the cigarette, literally, I have it dangling in my lip, half of it saturated with blood, the other half still alight. And I suppose the accountant's brain was saying, with a couple of puffs left in that, we don't want to waste any there, and that's the state I got to. I knew it was going to kill me, but that didn't stop me.
Is it very difficult for you?
For me, yeah, because it's the adrenaline.
Well, I have tried for about six next week, but found out it's too much, so I got fat.
Eventually I'll probably give up, but not at the moment.
Every year, 50,000 people give up smoking on No Smoking Day. Next Wednesday, the 10th of March, is this year's No Smoking Day. If you'd like to give up, but you think that willpower alone won't be enough, you're in good company. We're about to meet a couple who both felt they needed a helping hand. And we've a special telephone number. I'll give you that at the end.
I smoke 30 to 40 cigarettes a day, and I've smoked ever since I was at school.
I started smoking when I was at college, which was a good few years ago now, and I smoke between 15 and 20 a day. We both want to give up smoking, mainly for health reasons. We both have a tendency towards bronchitis if we get colds. I suffer from high blood pressure and have a circulatory problem, so it just makes sense.
Equally important is pressure from my children. I think since they've been away at college, when they come home now, they have a greater impact on me than when they live with us all the time.
Well, I've decided to use the nicotine patches because I feel that the steady flow of nicotine will help the craving and to gradually wean me off it. With the patches, you cannot smoke, and that should stop me from cheating.
It is a mental problem as much as an addiction problem. And I'm hoping that psychotherapy will help me overcome that mental problem, which will then enable me to apply my willpower and stick to the decision to give up smoking.
Continue to smoke normally throughout the session.
The skin patches deliver nicotine through the skin, and usually within about an hour to an hour and a half you have a level where that's having an effect. Now, you don't get the surge of nicotine, which is what you get when you smoke a cigarette. With the patches, you get a slow increase of nicotine and a low background level all through the day. No high peaks, no surges, and therefore long-term addiction is not a problem.
The side effects have in fact been quite minimal. The main one has been an unpleasant taste in the mouth. That has been the worst one.
That can happen on nicotine withdrawal. It's not common. It's a rare side effect. Usually your taste improves dramatically when you stop smoking.
Now, you also say that you are partly stopping because of pressure from other people. Can I just ask you where that pressure is coming from?
It's my children primarily.
It's all very altruistic and noble to think that you're stopping for somebody else. However, it makes the process...
It is an interreactive session. We remove the illusion that smokers suffer, that they're getting some sort of genuine pleasure or crutch from smoking. We thereby remove the fear of stopping smoking, the fear that they're not going to be able to cope with life or enjoy life without cigarettes.
I don't think I was misled by the advertising regarding the patches. I think I probably misled myself, thinking it was going to be a simple, easy method that would make me from a smoker to a non-smoker just by sticking on a patch. And it's not 100% that. There is a certain amount of mental attitude that has to be altered as well.
I've got a feeling of elation that I have thrown the habit. Confidence that I will continue not to smoke. And that I don't want to smoke. And it is a good feeling.
If you'd like more information on how to give up smoking, please write to Lifeline, No Smoking, P.O. Box 111, Stourbridge, DY8 1PZ. Please enclose a large self-addressed envelope with 45 pence postage. The information is available in large print if you request it. You can also phone Quitline on 071 487 3000 between 9:30 in the morning and 10 in the evening on weekdays. That's it. I'll be back with another Lifeline next week. Bye-bye for now. Thank you.